Hey guys, welcome back to another Chit Chat with Cass. So I was a bit worried when I started outlining this podcast because of the potential outcry or hate. But I'm lucky enough to have great followers, viewers, and/or listeners. So even if we don't agree, we can simply agree to disagree without being total assholes to each other. So in today's episode, I thought I would dive into and chat about some movies that I enjoy that people hate. I thought about doing this episode for a while now and started making up a list of like hated movies, I guess you could say. Now, as I said, in the masses, like people really dislike these films I'm going to be talking about, while I actually enjoy them. I like these movies. Are any of these movies perfect films? No. In no way are they perfect. They shouldn't be winning any awards or anything like that, but like, damn, sometimes people are just like so harsh. I don't know if I'm just not harsh on movies, like, or what the case is, but I actually enjoy these movies and I defend them. Even when people, like, tend to look at me like I'm batshit crazy, I will still defend a movie if I like it. Sometimes I feel like people have to, like, pick apart everything these days. Hollywood is also not perfect. I've talked about that, you know, a few times. It's less than original ideas and, like, you know, the odd movie choices or remakes, things like that. But can we just, like, sit back, relax, enjoy a movie without it needing to be like award-winning perfection? Like, can we just be entertained? Can it just be entertainment without like ripping everything to shreds? Now, I will be fair, that's a big point. I'll point out things that don't work in these films while also saying some things that I do love about them. I will also make this episode spoiler-free for you guys, just in case any of you have not seen some of these movies I'm going to be talking about. I will, of course, discuss the films, but just leave out the spoilers. I don't like ruining any sort of movie plots for people. So without further ado, let's go ahead and dive into these movies that I like and enjoy that most people hate. So first up, we have a movie from 2004 starring Hugh Jackman and Kate Beckinsale, and that is Van Helsing. The notorious monster hunter is sent to Transylvania to stop Count Dracula, who is using Dr. Frankenstein's research and a werewolf for some sinister purpose. So this, of course, is all about monsters, werewolves, vampires, Frankenstein, and so on. So of course, I was super interested in this movie, like when it like the trailers first started coming out. I'm also a fan of Hugh Jackman and Kate Beckinsale. So with this movie, they kind of like took their pieces of like monster stories, monster history, and merged them into a new or different story that is slightly familiar, but also has new takes onto the classic ideas as well. I mean, when you think to Van Helsing, often it's like an older guy, it's not Hugh Jackman. So that was kind of a different take on that casting. I tend to think of like Peter Cushing, he played Van Helsing in like 1958. I also think to the older guy that was in Monster Squad and he played Van Helsing. So Hugh Jackman's version is a bit of a newer take, and he is also a less conventional monster hunter, if you will. He has like all these gadgets that help him, like a reloading crossbow and things like that. So it definitely throws in like a modern ideas while still keeping it a dated movie, and I do enjoy that part to this. I also really love Kate Beckinsale's character, Anna. She should probably be on my favorite characters list because I was all about her when this movie came out. I'm pretty sure I tried to recreate her outfits like a few different times because I just thought she always looked badass. She was badass. Like, she's a very strong female character. So yes, both of them I really enjoyed, as well as some of the other characters of this story. As well as some of the other characters or stories in this movie. I know a lot of people don't care for how Frankenstein looks in this film. They did step away from like the more traditional Frankenstein look. Others also don't care for Richard Roxburgh as Dracula, but I thought that he was like super creepy in the part, so I was actually okay with it. I also enjoyed his three vampire chicks. You know, in different versions like of Dracula, I swear he always has like the three chicks, right? And it's always a blonde, a redhead, and a brunette. And I do enjoy them in this movie as well. But people do have a problem with the casting for this film, or the merging of different stories, basically. Like relating it to like one specific family or kingdom of sorts, when in reality, like, Dracula is separate from, like, you know, Frankenstein compared and Wolf Elfman. Like, they're all, like, separate things, but this movie, like, really merges it all together as, like, one big thing. This movie does try to be, like, a darker gothic scary movie, kind of, but there is also comedy in it as well. So, you really wouldn't consider this to be, like, a horror movie. At least I wouldn't. But it's not a straight-out comedy, either. It merges and goes, like, back and forth on the themes, I guess you could say. The CGI is also questioned. Things like transformations and backgrounds, which I understand. It is a bit cartoony, but it's not, like, horrible. It doesn't ruin the film for me. I also think that you can't really compare it to today's CGI because it was made in 2004. So that's 14 years ago, and the tech has, like, gone crazy over that time. So you can't really compare today's CGI to the CGI that was being made back then, in my opinion. I do have to laugh when people say that this movie isn't realistic in its stunts or effects. Like, bro, it's a movie about vampires, werewolves, and Frankenstein. It doesn't exactly have to be realistic, guys. Like, come on. But hey, I think it's a good adventure fantasy film. Okay, next up we have a movie from 2008, and it's starring Harrison Ford and Cate Blanchett. That is Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. In 1957, archaeologist and adventurer Dr. Henry Indiana Jones Jr. is called back into action and becomes entangled in a Soviet plot to uncover the secret behind mysterious artifacts known as the Crystal Skulls. So this movie is easily the most hated Indiana Jones movie, and when it came out, people were not a fan of it. Me, on the other hand, I was pumped for this movie. I love the Indiana Jones films, and I was so happy and excited when they announced another one. I was just, like, really ready for it. Especially when I heard that Karen Allen was going to be coming back. And of course, Harrison Ford. So this movie takes place in the 50s, and that ties in greatly to the theme of this movie compared to the others. A lot of people do not like the sci-fi alien look into Indiana Jones, but it fits so well into the 1950s sci-fi theme, I think it works great. So that was never a problem for me because I thought that it fit in nicely to that specific time period. Being as it is the whole point of this movie, that is a big reason that people dislike it. Others don't like that Karen Allen came back or don't like her acting, which, it hurts my heart. I was so excited to see her back and I enjoyed her so much in this movie. I just don't agree with that statement whatsoever. I would much rather they bring in someone back that, you know, we are familiar with instead of introducing a new character that we have no history with whatsoever. Shia LaBeouf was really popular at the time in Hollywood, so it's safe to say that's probably why he was casted in this part, and I do not hate him. I'm actually a fan of his. I don't dislike him, like, not at all. I actually really enjoy his acting, but this was another problem that people had. They were not a fan of his, I guess, for this specific role, but like I said, I was a fan, so I didn't have a problem with it. All in all, I like the tiebacks to the other three movies. I like the acting in it, and I enjoy the story, too. I actually do quote this movie quite often, but I don't want to spoil any of the quotes for you, but it has some great little comedic lines that I say quite often. My least favorite part in this movie has to do with some of the, like, iffy CGI and kind of, like, swinging through the trees. If you've seen the movie, then you know what I'm talking about. It didn't look good then, and it doesn't look good now, so that is probably my least favorite part of this film, just something that I did not enjoy about Crystal Skull. I mean, granted, I haven't seen Temple of Doom in years, but as of right now, I like Crystal Skull more than I like Temple of Doom. I never cared for that movie, which, you know, it's not the case for a lot of people. My order is actually a little bit different than most people. You know, my order is Last Crusade, Raiders, Crystal Skull, and then Temple of Doom. I don't know. Maybe I'm weird. I might be rare on this, obviously. I think it's a fact that I'm rare on this, but I defend this movie a lot. And I hear they might be making another one, so we will see how that goes, all the sequels in Hollywood. But yeah, I think it's supposed to be coming out in like 2020 or 2021. I'm not entirely sure, but I hear they're making another one. All right, guys, next up we have a movie from 1978 starring Roy Scheider, and that is Jaws 2. Police Chief Brody must protect the citizens of Amity after a second monstrous shark begins terrorizing the waters. So, no Jaws movie will ever beat the first one, okay? That is safe to say. It's a safe statement. But I was actually extremely surprised and shocked to hear that Jaws 2 is so hated. Because I love Jaws 2. I first saw it when, like, clearly, I was young. And I was super excited that there were kids involved in this storyline. Like, the whole point of this sequel really is the kids and teens being involved this time around. So I guess you could say, like, I connected to that. Like, watching as a kid and seeing young characters, I really enjoyed that about this sequel. I just love this movie. You know, people say it's, like, it's a horrible sequel and it has no plot, and that just doesn't make sense to me because I really enjoy this movie. I had no idea that so many people dislike Jaws 2. Like, gosh, so negative you guys are. I was truly surprised to hear that people just hate this movie so much. I'll watch it anytime it's on TV. I just, I don't know what else to say. I love, like, a lot of the characters. Like, the whole group of kids in this is great. Well, except for one of them. But I enjoy the acting. There's also some great lines in this movie as well that I quote. But I enjoy the group aspect of this film. All the kids experiencing this together, and the adventure aspect, and of course Brody's part of this sequel as well, which I think is super realistic to me, because the politics of a small town are gonna be shitty, and that definitely shows in this sequel here. The Jaws sequels will never be as good as the first one. I know this. We know this. But give it a chance. Just to briefly touch on 3 and 4, they are also hated. I will not defend 3 because it is pretty bad. You know, I do watch it on occasion. I'm not quite the hater as some people, but it's got lots of bad effects and there's a lot of problems with 3. Jaws 4 I do enjoy, as crazy as it is. It came out in 87 and it's called Jaws the Revenge. I've heard lots of problems with this movie from reviews or people just sharing their opinions, and I do see their point to some of it. There's a lot of things that were cut out compared to the book that kind of make things a little clearer, if you will. I started watching this movie once again when I was very young and into the other movies, clearly. So I liked it, and I had the video game to go with it. But yes, I still watch Jaws 4, The Revenge, but I openly see the bad points that people, you know, that they mentioned. Maybe I'm just not as harsh as some of these other people, I guess. I don't know. My favorite order for the Jaws movies is Jaws, Jaws 2, Jaws the Revenge, and then last is Jaws 3. Next up, diving into some superhero movies. I know that there are some harsh opinions about superhero movies, comic movies, and so on. I don't think I'm diving into any of the real crazy ones. I mean, I haven't even actually seen the Daredevil movie or Elektra. I know that those are, you know, not exactly fan favorites. But I've never seen them. So I'm actually going to be talking about a movie that came out in 2005 starring Ian Grofford and Jessica Alba. That is Fantastic Four. A group of astronauts gain superpowers after cosmic radiation exposure and must use them to oppose the plans of their enemy, Dr. Victor Von Doom. So, the mixed thoughts on these movies. I know a lot of people are not a fan of the casting, and I totally understand that. Jessica Alba was not comic book accurate for Sue Storm. Do I hate her in these movies? No, I do not. But, you know, she wasn't the soccer mom type character that is more comic related. I also know that a lot of comic book fans do not like what they did with Ben's character. Some actions and choice were not true to his character, and I know that, like, many people had issue with that. And I totally understand that problem. Like, people want things to be accurate and true to character, especially when you're dealing with comic book things. So I can't really fault anyone for those dislikes with this Fantastic Four movie. I get that it's also not one of the better hero movies, especially when you start to compare it to, you know, the superhero movies that we get today. But I do still enjoy it. I enjoy the acting. I don't think any of it's bad. I actually really like Julian McMahon as Doom, but I like the story, the action, them getting their powers, like how they're using their powers. I really don't think it's as bad as some people say. Honestly, this might have been one of the first Marvel, like, universe movies that I really got into, because I did not grow up with Marvel stuff. I grew up with DC, so this movie might have been, like, one of my main introductions into Marvel stuff. Now, when you compare this movie to the newer one that came out in 2015, ugh, dear God, no, 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 no. I think that might be one of the most disliked movies ever, and I have to agree with that one. Like, I won't hate on it, guys, but it is not for me. I saw it one time. I was so disappointed. I am not a fan. I will not watch it again. I hope they don't make any more of it because I was just disappointed. I will take the 2005 movie over the 2015 remake any day. Next up, we have a movie that came out in 2011 starring Emily Browning and Jenna Malone, and that is Sucker Punch. A young girl is institutionalized by her abusive stepfather, retreating to an alternate reality as a coping strategy, envisioning a plan to help her escape. This is one of those movies where I don't think people fully understand it, but that's one of the huge things that I like about it. In some ways, it's up for the viewer and each viewer to make up their mind on what exactly is happening. Like, what the hell is going on? When, where, and why? You don't get complete answers. So really, like, I really like this movie. It's a Zack Snyder movie, which is a little surprising for me because his style of things I'm not always on board with. Like, some of the things that he's doing, like, with the DC universe, I'm not a fan of. But I guess, like, this movie is an exception because I adore the style of this movie. I love this movie as a whole. I'm also a big fan of Emily Browning, so I love that she is kind of like the star in this, but the whole cast is great in my opinion. The look to this movie is also very cool or pretty, I guess you could say. I don't know, it's different. The way it's filmed and the effects within it, you really like get into like a vintage-esque, but it's obviously modern with the Cameron shots. It's obviously like green screen and CGI and different aspects to this movie. But like, it still has that like vintage feel to it, in my opinion. Let's see. Some people say that this movie is very hollow, doesn't have a point, doesn't make sense. The story is pointless. And while I could see why you might feel that way, I think it really is a movie that you have to come up with a few things in your head. You have to come up with your opinion or your thought on what is happening. It is not a straightforward film. It makes you think sometimes on what is happening to the character while the action sequence is happening or redirecting the viewer. There is a lot to think about, which might be a bit too much for some viewers. I know some people think this movie was just like a popcorn flick, you know, one of those sorts of movie that you just is mindless fun or has one thing going for it, like special effects or like hot chicks, and it has nothing else. It doesn't have a core, some people would say. But I think this movie is a much more deeper than that, but maybe that's just me. I really enjoy different theories on what's happening or kind of like being lost in the mind through these different sequences because there is a lot going on within the characters and especially within the main character's mind. So I enjoy this movie. Next, we have a movie from 2009 starring Shia LaBeouf and Megan Fox, that is Transformers Revenge of the Fallen. Sam Witwicky leaves the Autobots behind for a normal life, but when his mind is filled with cryptic symbols, the Decepticons target him and he is dragged back into the Transformers war. Now, being totally honest, I lost interest in this series after the third one, and I have not seen any of the new movies. But I know that this sequel specifically got a lot of hate. People just did not like it. But I'm also an odd one, you know? I'm a weird one because I actually like Revenge of the Fallen way more than I like the first one. Yes, you might be shocked by that, but I do. I really like some things that Sam goes through in this one. I enjoy Shia LaBeouf's acting, his performance. As I said, I'm a fan of his. You know, his brain kind of is frying a bit with this information. He's trying to process and he's trying to share it, like, and with the connection to the Autobots and the Decepticons, I really like this sequel. The cast altogether I enjoy, and I find it to be a very enjoyable movie, an entertaining movie. And I'm not a huge fan of action films, but this, of course, has adventure and sci-fi aspect to it as well, so kind of gives me other things to like about it. I know a lot of people have issues with Megan Fox in this part for the movies, which is okay, that's fine. I think she's kind of hit or miss for a lot of people, but she doesn't bother me like she does others, so it's fine. I do, of course, enjoy the first Transformers movie, but this sequel, Revenge of the Fallen, I just enjoy it like so much more. I like some of the storyline, as I said, some of the stuff that Sam is going through. I just really enjoy the sequel, and I think it gets unneeded hate. So next up we have one that is a huge fan following and a huge hate group as well. The first one came out in 2008 and stars Kristen Stewart and Robert Pattinson. That would be Twilight or the Twilight Saga. A teenage girl risks everything when she falls in love with a vampire. So yes, I was a big Twilight fan. I was all about the vampire craze, you know, Twilight, Vampire Diaries, True Blood, all that jazz. But it started when Twilight got so popular. My friend actually had me read the books and then of course I saw the films as well. Now, Twilight is easily like a teen vampire movie. You know, it's, you know, it was all about these young teens loving the series and are you team Edward? Are you team Jacob? But To be fair, there were a lot of adults that were into this series too, you know. I went to a lot of midnight showings for this series and sat by a lot of adults. Like, you know, there was a bunch of teenagers there, a bunch of us, but then there was a lot of adults there too, not just like with their kids, like they went by themselves. So it's not just a teen movie. But anyway, these movies get so much hate. And I get it for maybe some adults, it's not your thing or whatever, but it's just a fun, like, teen series. Like, calm down. Let people like what they like. I know it did get a little crazy, but, like, teen girls especially, they obsess over whether it's a band or, like, a musician or a movie or a TV show. You know, it's kind of what a lot of teens do. So when Twilight became so popular with, like, the teenagers, was it really all that surprising? Because that's kind of what teenagers do. I still watch these movies. I'm very partial to the first one because it was filmed here in the Pacific Northwest, and I love the scenery that is very familiar to me. I'm very used to it, so I love the visual aspect to the first one. But the other movies are great as well. I'm also one of those people that loves the cast and everyone that plays either the different family members, the different characters in town, and so on. And no, I do not hate Kristen Stewart. She gets made fun of a lot because of how she delivers lines or how she pauses during scenes, but I really like her. I love how she acts, and I constantly defend her to people because I actually love her acting style. Like, not just in Twilight. Yes, I am a Twilight fan, but I think she's great in movies like Adventureland. Welcome to the Rileys is really great. Hell, she played Joan Jett in The Runaways, and I thought she did a great job in that as well. I'm a fan of Kristen Stewart, so, you know, deal with it. I will defend her to anyone. But yes, I openly share my love for the Twilight series, even as people bash it or bash me for enjoying it. I like it, guys, and hopefully you can accept my little Twilight heart. All right, next up, we have a movie from 1999 starring Liam Neeson and Ewan McGregor. That would be Phantom Menace, guys. Two Jedi Knights escape a hostile blockade to find allies and come across a young boy who may bring balance to the Force, but the long dormant Sith resurface to claim their old glory. So for this one, guys, I'm not going to go like too deeply into this because my dad and I do have our Star Wars series on this podcast, but like, let's just talk about the prequels real quick. Yes, I do not hate them like everyone else does. Star Wars fans are so picky. They're like picky as fuck. My God. Like, I love Star Wars people, but some of them need to take a chill pill. There are some really big assholes and bullies in this fandom that is just unfortunate. Like, calm down. Now, are the prequels perfect? No, absolutely not. They are not. And they are not like the originals. But I still watch the prequels and I can enjoy parts of them. Now, don't get me wrong. I do pick apart some of the things and laugh about others. But I'm not going to, you know, bully Jake Lloyd. That poor kid got so much backlash for Phantom Menace and hate. It was ridiculous. Like, he was a child, guys. It's just like, poor kid. Like, the backlash and the hate is just ridiculous. I can't wrap my head around people that hate or freak out at people for, like, a character when the actor didn't write the movie. And he was, like, he was a kid. Poor guy. And you know what's sad is it's still happening today. Because the actress that played Rose in Last Jedi, Kelly Marie Tran, just got bullied off social media. Like, guys, don't be so hateful. If you don't like a movie, that's fine. But it's not the actor's fault. Just, like, calm. Find a zen place. Watch some ASMR or something. Jesus. So my dad and I are actually starting into the prequels next. Next up, we will be doing Phantom Menace. So you will hear, like, that it's not my favorite. Like, the prequels are not some of my favorites, but, and I do have issues, of course, with them, but I still enjoy them. It's still Star Wars content that I can find entertaining. There are still parts that are some of my favorite, even if it's not perfect. Same goes for Attack of the Clones and Revenge of the Sith. I just wanted to add the prequels into this because I know that they get a lot of hate because how picky some Star Wars fans are. And I get it. They are not perfect. They are not the originals. They are not what we were expecting, but I can still appreciate them. All right, next up we have a movie that kind of broke a record by its trailer being the most disliked on YouTube. It came out in 2016, starring Melissa McCarthy and Kristen Wiig, and that is Ghostbusters, but apparently they changed the name to Ghostbusters Answer the Call. Following a ghost invasion of Manhattan, paranormal enthusiasts Aaron Gilbert and Abby Yates, nuclear engineer Jill Holtzman, and subway worker Patty Tolan band together to stop the otherworldly threat. Okay, guys. People hate this movie, like, with a passion. And I am a huge fan of the original movies, so I'm kind of in an interesting place here. Like, the original movies are some of my favorite films. I could watch them over and over again, and I do watch them over and over again. I could probably quote all the movies. Like, I could probably quote the whole thing, because I love Ghostbusters 1 and Ghostbusters 2. So when this remake was announced, I was kind of like, eh, let's see what they do, you know, oh, here we go with another remake, they're remaking everything. I was curious about it, and I needed to see more. When the trailer dropped, it was so disliked that, like I said, it was like the most disliked video on YouTube, which is crazy. You hate a movie so much after one trailer? Maybe, as I said, I am more open or not as harsh on things, I don't know. But I'd rather give a film a chance to entertain me or to enjoy it, because before I immediately decide that it's shit after one trailer. Like, I need more than that to decide if I like a movie. The idea to change the characters to women pissed off a lot of people as well, which, you know, whatever. I don't know if it's because, like, I'm female, but it didn't bother me. But, you know, guys that I know weren't bothered by it either. So people really get up all in their feels about that type of shit when, like, characters like that are changed. It's probably the same people that say Star Wars isn't for girls, but whatever. The cast in this, I fully enjoy. All four girls I thought were really funny, and I enjoyed them. Like, Kate McKinnon stole the show. I freaking love her character in this. I knew her from SNL, but, like, oh my god, she was fantastic in this. So funny. I was dying. So for this, I've read a lot of reviews about how the villain wasn't good enough or the CGI being a bit too much, and I could see that. I understand that. I'm not defending that at all. But I don't think that it should be one of, like, the worst movies in history. I don't agree with that, because it is comical. There are some parts that I really enjoyed. I don't think that it should be such a hated film. I do know that a lot of people took issue with Chris Hemsworth's character because he was, like, the ditzy secretary. And he was. He absolutely was. He was ridiculous. And people thought that it was stupid. And it's true. It was. But, you know, if we're being honest, that's happened to female characters over years and years of cinema. It's nothing new for a secretary character to have this ditzy aspect to them. But it was just different for people because he was a man this time. I actually made a review on this movie on my channel after I saw it in theaters, and I got so much hate because I liked it. But, you know, whatever, I'm not going to change my opinion to make the masses happy. If you don't like the movie, that's fine, but I'm allowed to enjoy it if I want to. Is it my favorite movie? No. Does it beat the originals? Never. Do I enjoy this and does it make me laugh? It does. So I enjoy it. So last up, I was trying to think of like a 10th movie to include in this. I was going over like hated lists or reviews to see what like the general public considers to be the most hated movies, if you will, and see which ones I disagree with. And I saw this one on there a few times and I thought like, wait, I like that movie. Let's talk about that movie. So it came out in 2012, starring Taylor Kitsch and Brooklyn Decker. A fleet of ships is forced to battle with an armada of unknown origins in order to discover the fraught their destructive goals. Battleship. I think I did mention that I can be picky about action films, like, sometimes. I just don't get into them as I do others. But this movie, I, like, really enjoy. I think it's a great action movie. It does have a sci-fi aspect to it, so maybe that's why I like it. But I find this super entertaining. You kind of have, like, different people experiencing this alien attack along the islands in different places, and each group is kind of doing something different. I love the cast and the characters. I think that this was probably the first thing that I ever saw Rihanna act in, and I really like her character. I like the idea of, like, Battleship, like, you know, the game, and kind of tying that to aliens. Like, I don't know. I just think that this is a very entertaining movie. I like it. I like its action sequences. And there is a scene in this movie that is epic. Like, it is on my list of top movie scenes because I love it so much. I said I won't spoil things, and I will not, but this scene that I love so much in this movie has to do with some veterans, and it is epic and fantastic. I love it. And I don't think that this movie should be so hated because it entertains me every time I watch it. All right, guys, thank you so much for listening to today's episode. I would love to hear your opinions about some of the movies that I mentioned today. Or do you have a movie that you really enjoy that people hate? I'd love to hear. I'm kind of wondering, like, you guys will have to let me know if you like this idea. A few times when I've, like, watched some, like, award-winning movies or Oscar-winning movies, like, I haven't enjoyed them. Like, I don't know, maybe they're not for me. Or they're just, like, aren't as good as everyone makes them out to be. So my question, should I watch some, like, award-winning movies and do a podcast about them? You know, today I'm obviously talking about hated movies, and I've done 2 episodes about my favorite movies, and I'm wondering if I should do, like, a thoughts about the movies that are supposed to be the best out there. If they've won an Oscar, if they've won a different award, they're supposed to be the best. Should I see what my opinion is on them? What do we think? You'll have to let me know, guys. If I do that, I'll probably ask you guys on social media which movies to watch. So that's just an idea. We'll toy with it. All right, guys, thank you so much for listening to Chit Chat with Cass, and I will see you guys in the next episode.